Welcome you all for today's class. Today we are going to discuss about the brain tumors in children. So if you see regarding the brain tumors, there are primary brain tumors which is the second most common malignancy in childhood after the leukemia, out of which two-third are infratentorial. That is, infratentorial means it is located in the posterior fossa. So if you see, the more common infratentorial tumors are medulloblastoma, cerebellar astrocytoma, brainstem glioma and ependymoma. Usually if you see, the infratentorial brain tumors present with a raised ICP and hydrocephalus signs. So this is the second most common malignancy, and the two-thirds constitute the infratentorial. Next part, one-third is supratentorial, and in those supratentorial tumors, they are astrocytomas, craniopharyngioma, ependymoma, choroid plexus papillomas, pineal body tumors. Usually, child with supratentorial tumors present with focal seizures, focal motor weakness and language disorders. So, if you see, infratentorial present with raised ICP features and supratentorial present with mainly seizure and weakness. So, this is the differentiating feature between the supra and infratentorial tumors. So, based upon the location of the tumors, age-wise, there is a priority. So, if you see location of tumors age-wise, like in less than 1 year age group, supratentorial is more common, and that too, the choroid plexus tumor, particularly choroid plexus papillomas are more common and teratomas. So, in the childhood age group, that is between 1 to 10 years, infratentorial is more common, and that too, medulloblastoma and juvenile pilocytic astrocytoma are more common tumors in this age group. And if you see more than 10 years, again supratentorial becomes predominant, and that too, diffuse astrocytoma is more common in more than 10 years of age group. So, initially it is supratentorial, then infratentorial, then again it is supratentorial. So, this thing you have to remember. So, coming to the familial syndromes, some syndromes are associated with the pediatric brain tumors. That is, these syndromes definitely pediatric brain tumors will be a part of association. So, in that way, in the neurocutaneous syndromes, we might have read about this neurofibromatosis type 1 and 2, von Hippel-Lindau tuberous sclerosis. So, if you see, definitely the central nervous system manifestations like optic gliomas, astrocytoma, and malignant nerve sheath tumors and neurofibromas. So, regarding brain tumors, if you see astrocytomas associated with the neurofibromatosis type 1. In type 2, usually the brain tumors are meningiomas and ependymomas and astrocytomas. And in von Hippel-Lindau, if you see hemangioblastoma, and in tuberous sclerosis, it is subependymal giant cell astrocytoma, and cortical tubers are associated with the tuberous sclerosis complex. And other syndromes like Leaf-Romani syndrome, where astrocytoma is a predominant brain tumor, and in Cowden syndrome, where the gangliocytoma of the cerebellum is a predominant tumor, and in Turcot syndrome, it is medulloblastoma and glioblastoma, and in nevoid basal cell carcinoma, the medulloblastoma. So, in general, if you see, astrocytomas, meningiomas, ependymomas and medulloblastomas. So, these are all the common pediatric brain tumors associated with the familial syndromes. So, we'll see about the common brain tumors one by one. So, moving on to the first brain tumor, which is the medulloblastoma. Medulloblastoma is basically the midline cerebellar tumors. It usually affects the young children. And if you see the neuroimaging, it reveals the midline mass that arising from the vermis, and it effaces into the fourth ventricle and the basal cisterns, and thereby it causing the obstructive hydrocephalus. So, this is the medulloblastoma, and if you see 90% of the embryonal CNS tumors is the medulloblastoma only. And if you see, boys are more frequently affected compared to girls, that is 2 to 4 times as often than girls, and median age of occurrence is around 5 to 7 years, and these are rapidly growing malignant tumors, and they present with a cerebellar signs and features of raised ICT. Okay, so characterized mainly by the histological presence of Homer right rosettes and immunopositivity for synaptophysin. So these are all the pointers you have to remember while writing the question on medulloblastoma. So the most common type of embryonal CNS tumor, which is basically midline cerebellar tumor, boys more commonly affected than girls, and it is a rapidly growing malignant tumor. And the two characteristic histologic findings are Homer right rosettes and immunopositivity for synaptophysin. So this is regarding the medulloblastoma, and 40% they have evidence of CSF seeding at the time of diagnosis.